What if you wake up one day only to see a video of the head of a superpower declaring war on your country? Well, most likely that would be a deepfake video. Novel digital technologies have made it increasingly difficult to distinguish between real and fake media. We are living in a time where one of the more recent developments contributing to this problem is readily accessible, known as deepfakes, which are just hyper-realistic videos that apply artificial intelligence to depict someone say or do things that never happened in the first place. Fake news has already become a major threat to the public, and democracy and deepfakes make things even more dangerous. So make sure to watch the video till the end to know more about how artificial intelligence and deepfake would change the way you see and hear things from now on. The rise in popularity of online content, all thanks to platforms like Instagram, TikTok, Snapchat, and YouTube, make it extremely difficult to confirm whether something is real or fake because of how easy it is to share online content. Recent technological advancements made it extremely easy to create what we now call deepfakes, which are hyper-realistic videos made using face swaps that leave little trace of manipulation. Deepfake technology originated in 2017 when an anonymous Reddit user called himself Deepfakes. The Reddit user manipulated Google's open-source deep learning technology to create and post manipulated pornographic video. These videos were doctored with the technique known as face swapping. The user replaced real faces with celebrity faces. These are created using artificial intelligence software that merge, combine, replace, and superimpose images and video clips to create fake videos that look extremely authentic. And it could convince you to believe that whatever you're seeing or hearing is the truth. Consider this to be an advanced form of Photoshop, but for video and audio, with machine learning as the key ingredient to manipulate visual and audio content, making fake news look extremely convincing, even to the trained eye. In an internet-centric era, AI forgeries have become a cybersecurity concern, not just on corporate, national, or international levels, but also on an individual level. Here's how it works. Machine learning and deepfake synthesizing technology creates what are known as voice skins, or clones in simpler terms, which enable someone to pose as a prominent figure, either in the form of a video or photo. To make a deepfake video of someone, all you need to do is train a neural network using many hours of real footage of the person. It then gives the network a realistic understanding of how he or she appears from various angles and lighting conditions. The trained network is then combined with several computer graphic techniques. This superimposes a copy of the person onto another actor. Even with the help of AI, it still takes time to produce a believable composite that places a person in a completely fictional situation. Creators must also tweak many of the trained program parameters, making this not as easy as it may look like, even though it is a lot easier than it used to be. Several social media posts supported by convincing manipulations have the potential to misguide and inflame the internet. There are several ways to create a deepfake. One way is a method known as Generative Adversarial Network, or GAN, which is used for face generation. It produces faces that otherwise don't exist. GAN uses two separate neural networks, or a set of algorithms designed to recognize patterns, that work together by training themselves to learn characteristics of a real person so that they can produce images that are extremely convincing but fake. These two networks are engaged in a complex interplay that interprets data by labeling, clustering, and classifying the source material. One network generates the images, and the other network learns how to distinguish fake images from real. The algorithm can then train itself on photos of a real person to generate fake videos of that real person, and can also turn those photos into convincing videos. The other way to create deepfakes would be with the help of artificial intelligence encoders. Encoders are used in face swapping or face replacement technologies. For this, you need to feed thousands of face shots of two people to the encoder to find similarities between the two images. Then, the second AI algorithm decoder retrieves the face and swaps them. This way, a person's real face can be superimposed on another person's body. Deep face scams are designed to make you believe that the voice on the other side is of someone you know. It could be someone influential, your boss, or even your client. Chances are high that you trust these people, so you won't suspect them if they ask you for some monetary favors. Deep fakes are simply an extension of the video concept that we have been using for decades. Video compositing usually requires a lot of video skills, time, and equipment, which means that most people simply don't have access to this technology. But with deepfakes, a creator needs less skill, time, and equipment to create a deepfake, even if they are often unconvincing to the careful observers. Machine learning is the reason why the production of deepfakes is much faster and cost-effective. Now, there are several positives for the deepfake technology. Deepfakes can assist a teacher in delivering engaging lessons, and these lessons could go beyond traditional visual and media formats. For example, it could bring historical figures back to life in the classroom, which makes lessons more engaging and interactive, making synthetic media a more effective learning tool. Deepfake also has the potential to democratize expensive VFX technology that was only accessible to people with the right skills and a lot of money to invest in. It has also become a powerful tool for independent storytellers at a fraction of the cost. This means that it can open up several opportunities in the entertainment industry, as we are already seeing several independent creators and YouTubers seizing this opportunity. Another interesting use case for synthetic voice or deepfake audio is with storytelling and book narration. Imagine listening to an audiobook narrated by the author's synthetic voice. Businesses can also broaden the reach of the content by using synthetic voiceovers of the same actor in multiple different languages. Human rights activists and journalists can also use synthetic media to remain anonymous in oppressive and dictatorial regimes. Citizen journalism and activists can also gain a lot of power by using technology to report atrocities on traditional or social media. Deepfakes can also be used to mask the identity of people and faces to protect their privacy, and that is a double-edged sword. It's a no-brainer that deepfakes are known to deceive viewers with manipulated and fake content, and its creators want you to believe something that was said or happened that never really occurred. Today, deepfakes are used to create hoaxes, celebrity pornography, reputation smearing, election manipulation, misinformation attacks, identity theft, blackmail, financial fraud, and so on. Companies are extremely concerned about the scams that rely on deepfake technology, as the voice and images of top-level executives can be used to bring the company down or to deal with unauthorized monetary transactions. So how can you prevent something like this from happening in the first place? Truth be told, it's no easy task, considering the fact that this technology is readily accessible. Social media platforms like Twitter and Facebook have already banned the use of these nefarious types of deepfakes, but it's still a good idea to be aware of what you see and what you hear from social media and not take it completely for its face value. Deepfakes could also lead to what is known as the liar's dividend effect, where someone like a political figure denies the authenticity of a video that may not be a deepfake. So when real evidence for something is produced, these people get away with it by calling it fake, and when the media attempts to expose the lie, it can backfire and make the lie sound more credible. It's also hard to prove both sides, making the mere existence of deepfakes a potentially powerful political tool, as political videos have become so prevalent and damaging that the state of California, for example, has outlawed them during election seasons with a goal to keep deepfakes from deceptively swaying voters. The problem does not end there. When the creators of detection algorithms respond to the latest deepfake with their new technology, people behind those deepfakes also respond to the new technology that is used to detect deepfakes, which means it's evolving on both sides of the algorithm. This way, the battle is going back and forth, but it's still good to know that deepfakes can still be spotted, but not by everybody. So, if you're watching a video online, make sure that you are watching it from a reputable source before believing what you see and sharing it with others. Now is not the right time to believe everything that you see and hear on the web, and don't share any suspicious media messages to your friends and family, which will just expand its reach, and that's exactly what deepfake creators want you to do. If you think something is totally unbelievable, chances are high that it might be a deepfake. Deepfakes ultimately offer a fantastic opportunity to make a positive impact in our life, but because of the fact that this technology is easily accessible, the risk of exploitation is extremely high. Deepfakes can smear people's reputation by fabricating evidence and portraying them in the wrong light. It can also completely take away the public's confidence in democratic institutions. Deepfakes might have its positives, but the negatives outweigh them, making this technology a tool that can be used to fool your eyes and ears.